Tim Hegarty with VTC C++ Fundamentals. Pointer types. Well, not a lot has changed here since C. Pointers can still hold the address of any type or object, including functions. Quite useful to be able to call a function by its address in memory. Some of the iterators that we have talked about in C++ containers are in fact pointers, like the iterator for a vector. That's really a pointer to the current element in the vector. Void pointers, as we know, don't point to any particular type or object. They can hold any address in memory. The smallest thing that a pointer can point to is still a character. Can't get any lower than that. And pointers can still be manipulated. You can increment them, decrement them, add a value to them, and they will increment or decrement depending on the size of the object that they point to. Manipulation is just the same as it was in C. And pointers are still very closely related to array subscripts. The address of the zeroth element of an array can be set into a pointer, and now the pointer points at the beginning of the array. And if it knows that it's an integer pointer and it's an array of integers, when you increment, you'll go forward by the number of bytes in an integer and decrement it, you know, so on, just like you did in C. There is still no bounds checking in C++ for pointer types, so you can run off the end of an array by incrementing past the end of valid memory and touching something that you shouldn't, which will probably produce a runtime exception. But our pointers are very much the same as they were in C, and they're actually used even more in some of the C++ containers that we talked about, and you're really better off using those containers than trying to create an array and manipulate it with pointers and things like that. Those things have been put into the standard library for you now.